What is the purpose of life? Talk to you briefly about this because it's an important question. And in today's society, people are so rushed and so preoccupied with the definition of success that they rarely have the time to stop and reflect on why are we here and what is this place? Most people act as though this is the end. This is an end. When in fact, this is not an end. This is just a beginning. This is the anteroom. This is the place where we come and spend 60, 70, 80, 90, 100 years or so preparing ourselves for the permanent world. And our obligation here is to develop our spiritual potential. And what is spirituality anyway? Spirituality means any process that involves diminishing our reactive tendencies and our egocentric posture, because the universe is about oneness. It is not about an individual. It's the collective, the reality of duality is unity, which as we say in the Shema, in Deuteronomy 6:4, hear, O Yisrael, Hashem, our God, Hashem is one. And we're talking about the ultimate reality being one creative intelligence that's beyond our ability to know. We have within that the Aleph-Bet, the expression of that creative intelligence given to us so that we may connect to that creative intelligence and have our vitality enlivened. So the purpose of life then is to seek out a technology of rectification because we believe that we are broken, fallen sparks of divinity, and we're here to tikkun. We're here to correct that through some form of discipline that it ends up impacting us in a way so that we are less egocentric and less reactive and more proactive toward facilitating our own development and maximizing our evolutionary potential. So it's a great joy now to have this format and to share with you some of the things that Hashem has shared with me, and to tell you that this is a phenomenon, something wonderful is happening. Na knock knock man knock man me human. First of all is the single, double, triple, quadruple song of redemption, and I am being redeemed. It's a personal story of redemption, a personal odyssey of coming from Alabama to go all the way to Yerushalayim to sit with the Tzaddik and to sit with King David and to visit the holy city of Sfat and take holy mikvahs there and to be given Lashon Chodesh, Lashon Choku Chodesh, Lashon HaKodesh, the holy language, the holy tongue, the tongue of God. So the purpose of life is to find a technology, and those of us who are Hebrew, you know, Jewish, we find this comes to us. It wasn't like I found anything. This came to me. And so life is a beautiful experience, a beautiful expression of the divinity of God, the light of God in each one of us, Hashem, and our intelligence and our soul. Our soul is our intelligence, and our name is our soul, and our intelligence allows us to act, think, and be, to be, think, and act from a certain platform of consciousness. So it's a great joy to share music with you, to share my story with you. It's just my story. It isn't a group story. I'm not a member of any group. I don't represent any group. I'm just Yeshua, an impulse of creative intelligence that was born in the diaspora. And my grandmother said, son, we are the Hebrew children, and one day you will go to the Holy Land. And that came to pass. While I was in the Holy Land, I met some holy Yehudis who said, let me introduce you to Rabbi Nachman of Breslov and his teaching. He is the great-grandson of the Baal Shem Tov, comes from a tradition of enlightened holiness, and he himself is a flowing stream of wisdom that you will come to know and appreciate if you read his writings and his work. And I've spent the last 7 years doing that because I'm conducting an experiment. My experiment is to validate Na na nachman mi uman as the single, double, triple, quadruple song of redemption. And does it redeem me? And in fact, it is redeeming me. It's giving me peace and love and wisdom and happiness and opening up the doors of mercy and ameliorating all judgment. It's a very profound reality, and I'm conducting the research on that. And may Hashem bless us all to be loving as we go forward. You know, we're some very racist people, and we have to, as our consciousness evolves, then that will fall off. What we have now is a tradition of racism, people who are fundamentally racist, who masquerade as holy people and who are fundamentally racist. That doesn't help to accomplish the goal of this holy nation that we, Israel, are, to be the light of this world and to tikkun olam. So we're here now to win away the divisions. We understand that divisions are part of the creative process because nature creates infinite diversity. It creates olive trees and banana trees and oak trees. It creates Chinaman. It creates Indian. It creates African. It creates infinite diversity. But we understand, because of our connection to Hashem, that that reality is one. There again, Hashem expressing himself as the subject and the object, and the relationship between the two always. So beautiful, so beautiful, so beautiful, so beautiful, so wonderful to have the experience of being resurrected from the dead. This is the resurrection. This is the long-awaited coming. The coming is coming. Well, the coming is coming because the first rays of the Mashiach come. And we can say, Shema Israel Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad. We can accept the Davidic yoke. We can accept the Davidic yoke, which means we accept Hashem, and say to Hashem, what can I do for you, rather than what can you do for me, which is the petitions of another group of people. It's all about somebody giving them some stuff. Well, we Israelites know that we already know that God is one. Now the commitment is from Exodus. I think you read this Exodus chapter 20, verse 2. Anoki Adonai Eloheka. And I was reading, Rabbi said that this was not a pronouncement, it was a mitzvah. I am to be your God, and so we have to accept that, and accepting that, it's taking on the Davidic yoke, which is a commitment to live holy in a holy life. This is a holy season, so something wonderful is happening. And especially I want those of you who may be unfamiliar with African Americans to see holiness emerging. Someone talking in this side about the Brit, someone having been made aware of the covenant, the meaning of the covenant that God made with Abraham, our forefathers, and our responsibility. It's a potential. Circumcision is a potential for holiness, but we have to live holy. But we, black people, were conditioned to live on a low level because of slavery and what the Christians taught us how to be immoral. And just let Jesus save us, which was, that's just poppycock, and that's no good. And now Hashem has come to say, Ani Adonai Eloheka, I am your God. I am to be your God. Will you accept that? And the answer is, yes, I accept it. And when you accept it, that's between you and him. It's not a group. Not a group saying, oh, now you come on and convert. No. No, it's God saying, you are my son, let me resurrect you from the dead, revivify you, and show you the way for you. Let me show you your unique corridor, because it's upon the corridor of your destiny that you meet Hashem. So it's a great joy to talk to you and play music for you. May Hashem bless each and every one of you, give you holy Shabbat, keep the Shabbat, and be loving in all that you do and say. Baruch Hashem. Mm-hmm.